Hey guys, what's going on? Today we are going to be continuing on with our Hack the Box series. Today we're going to be learning how to get Virtualbox and install Kali Linux inside of it, as well as connecting to Hack the Box using the VPN package that it allows you to download, and we'll be updating our machine and changing the root password for it. So let's go ahead and jump into it. So here we have VirtualBox, and I'll be leaving all the links in the description, so don't worry about, you know, pausing the video and trying to grab those. They'll be in the link or the description below. So first we come download VirtualBox, download it depending on what distribution you have, what OS you have. I have Windows, so I'm going to be downloading the Windows. If you have Max, OS X, grab that. If you have Solaris, grab that. And if you have Linux, grab that. We have Windows, so we'll go ahead and grab that there. It's fairly small, so it shouldn't take much time to download. And then we'll jump over here to Linux. We want the Kali Linux VirtualBox, since that's what we're getting, images. If you have a 32-bit architecture as your main system, grab that. If you have a 64-bit, grab that. I have 64-bit. Windows 10, so I'm going to go ahead and grab that. Most of you probably have a 64-bit, so if you're unsure what your architecture is, go ahead and just grab the 64. And this will take a little while to download depending on your internet speed. It's 3.1 gigs, so took me about 15 minutes, but I have fairly quick internet speeds. If you have, you know, very slow internet or such, probably take you a while, so you'll probably want to pause this video or maybe just go ahead and watch it all the way through just so you can figure out the steps while your OVA is downloading. So we'll drop this down, go ahead and bring up our virtual box. Oh wait, I forgot to show you how to install it, didn't I? Where are we at? Right here. So we can go ahead and open this up. Next, yes. And then you would click install. I'm not going to, because as you saw before, I've already got it. So I'm not going to go back through that process. And I already have two VMs in here. You won't have these, of course. So you would just click on tools, import, and then point to where you downloaded the file to. I downloaded it here into my downloads. So I'll click open. And then if we click next, we'll just accept all these same settings and import. I agree. That'll take a couple of seconds because it's basically unpacking the hard drive. Shouldn't take too terribly long though. So while this is going ahead and doing its thing, I'm going to talk to you guys for a moment. I really do appreciate you guys subscribing and liking my last video. And this is going to be a running thing. We're going to try and get a hack, do a tutorial on hacking every single box on HackTheBox eventually, but they continuously add more. So we may not ever get to where we're, you know, finished with all of them. So just a heads up there. But if you do like this content and you are planning on following along with any of these tutorials to learn how to do real hacking, go ahead and hit that subscribe and ring the notification bell so that way you're alerted as soon as I put out a new video. And I really, really do appreciate the support that you guys have given me thus far. So we click on the VM, we go to settings, and we can rename it. I'm just going to do Hack the Box Kali 2 Advanced. That looks good, fine. Good. Make sure you have enable 3D acceleration turned off. Storage looks good. Fine. I usually turn my audio off. You can leave it on, but there's like no need to. I turned mine to bridged adapter. If NAT works for you, it's better. But for whatever reason, my router will not work with me being behind NAT. I don't know. Ports, and we need to change USB to USB 1.1. That's, I don't know if you noticed, it's got a little thing down here. You need to change that to 1.1. Other than that, we are good to go. So let's go ahead and start this up. It'll take it a couple seconds to actually open up on this first initialization. And we go to whatever it is. Let's go over mouse. There we go. View. Okay. Disappeared. Dragged it over to my other screen. That's annoying. So we go to view, full screen. And the default is Kali. And Kali. First thing we're going to do once we get in here is open up a prompt, and we're going to change our default password. So that's PASSWD, and then I'm just going to put test 123. I forgot we got a sudo test sudo PASSWD, and that would be Kali. And now I can do test 123 and test 123. Now we can do a sudo apt get update. And that's basically going to just update any packages that are out of date, and then we'll do sudo apt get upgrade dash y, and that's going to go ahead and download all of the newer versions of everything for us. As you can see, it's doing quite a bit of stuff. So in the meantime, while that's running, we're going to come over here and go to web browser. It's doing a lot of stuff in the background, so it's going to go a little bit slow. Now, hackthebox.eu. And we'll go to login, and we'll go ahead and log in here. Save, and you'll be presented with the same screen we were at the other day. You're gonna want to come down here and go to access and download your connection pack here. Click that and save file. Okay, and as you can see here, we are not connected to the server right now. Now that that's downloaded, we will come here and open another command prompt that's saved in the downloads folder. So we'll cd downloads ls, there it is. So we can sudo aw. By the way, it'll be your username here, your username.obpn. So you do sudo openvpn and then your username. OVPN password, we just changed that to test 123. Basically, this is going to come through initialize, and at the end you should see, this is the most important thing you're really looking for, is initialization sequence complete. If we go back to hack the box, we refresh that. And now we can see that we're connected. We can see our IP address, our IPv6 IP address, our data transferred back and forth, port number that we're connecting from, and what server we're connected, what VPN server we're connecting to. You see here, I'm a member of VIP, so just to be fully disclosed there, it's like $13 a month. It's in euros. But the transition from English to from USD to euros is basically it comes up to $13 after taxes and whatnot. So now we can come here to machines, go to all, and we have our active machines. You can filter by numerous things: release date, name, user difficulty rating would probably be useful. And we'll complete and complete. We'll just have them all showing. And you can come through here and see these are going to be the hardest ones up to the easier ones. And then the retired machines over here. You can come through and see they have so many. It's ridiculous. It's like bordering on 200, I believe. All the way up to ridiculously hard. And that's pretty much it for this video. In the next video, we're going to cover actually hacking a box. We're going to be doing blue. And that will be the first box that we hack. We'll go from port scanning and figuring out what service is running, figuring out what vulnerability we're going to be able to get into. And we'll just go through the whole nine yards from beginning to end. And yeah, we'll go from there. I'll just do like one box per episode after this. But if you did like this video, please take your time to subscribe to me and ring the notification bell so that way you can be alerted whenever I make a new video. And I really do appreciate you stopping what you were doing and taking the time to watch this video. It really means a lot to me. It would mean a lot to me as well if you could leave a comment or leave a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, if you don't understand something I did, or you're getting stuck on something, please don't hesitate to contact me. I will get back to you, give you as much feedback as I can, and try to help you with your problem as best I can. Until the next video, thank you guys for watching.